Hello. We are doing another induction proof, this time with inequalities. So we are proving that 3 raised to n is less than n factorial for all n's greater than 6. Here, n is an integer. And I'm taking this question from Discrete Mathematics and Its Applications by Kenneth Rosen, the 7th edition, chapter 5.1, question 20. If you are familiar with the Rosen book, it's a good resource. I like it. That's why I'm continually taking problems from that book. I think it's pretty common amongst discrete math, college level discrete math. So it's fairly safe to pick problems from this. There's good examples of how to do induction and how to do induction on inequalities. I've found can be a little tricky for students. So I'm going to have a few videos here coming up where we are looking at inequalities. All right, so let's prove this. Again, by induction. So if you see any of my videos on induction proofs with summations and closed forms with equalities, this won't be that much different. The main difference here is the inequality itself. So let me maybe do a tad a bit of an aside. So the inequalities, let's use a really obvious example. I say 1 is less than 6. That's an obvious statement. Now, what we need to do sometimes with induction proofs and inequalities is we need to build from the left and from the right, build inequalities so that we can show by essentially transitivity that the left-hand side is less than or equal to the right-hand side. And the way we do that is say with this, we build some inequalities. 1 is less than 2 and 2 is less than 3. And I know that 6 is greater than 5, is greater than 4. Now, putting those two things together, those obvious statements, we can see that 1 is less than 2, is less than 3, is less than 4, is less than 5, is less than 6. Which shows that 1 is less than 6. So these inequality induction proofs will sometimes be very similar in the sense that we will be building inequalities from left or from the right or from both and try to meet somewhere in the middle. But the basic structure will be the same. We have a base case. We want to show that the statement holds for the first term. Now, notice here, we start at 7. So n is greater than 6. So we need to check that n equals 7 holds. Now, let's look at n as 0 just to see what happens here. So is it true that 3 raised to 0 is less than 0 factorial? Recall that 0 factorial is 1. So what we're saying here is 1 is less than 1 is false. So it doesn't hold for 0. Let's try 1. 3 raised to 1 is less than 1 factorial. Well, 3 raised to 1 is 1. 1 factorial is 1. This is false. So you can see there's a reason we're starting at 7. It's just not arbitrary. So the base case will be for 7. So we want to show that, is it true that 3 to the n is less than n factorial when 7 equals n? So let's look. Is 3 raised to the 7th less than 7 factorial? Now I did these obviously beforehand because I don't know off the top of my head what 3 to the 7 is or for that matter what 7 factorial is, but 3 to the 7th is 2,187, and 7 factorial is 5,040. Now recall factorial means that 7 factorial is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. I always include 1. I don't know why. You don't have to. Obviously, anything multiplied by 1 is 1 or itself. So it's how I think of factorials anyway. Okay, so the base case holds. That is indeed true. 5040 is indeed greater than 2187. So the base case holds. So let's look at the inductive step. And we can think of this as the statement of that PK is true. Here, we would say that we showed that P7, where P is the statement that we're trying to prove. So we are going to assume that the K case, the PK case, is true. In other words, we're going to assume that 3 raised to K is less than K factorial for K greater than 6. You can think of it as K greater than or equal to 7. The problem states K greater than 6. Okay, so that is the induction hypothesis. We're assuming that this is true. Now, if you watch enough of my videos, you know I like to write IH, and I often forget to write it inside the proof itself, but I do like to keep that little shorthand available. Okay, so we are assuming this is true. This is our induction hypothesis up from K greater than 6. So what do we want to show? We want to show essentially that the next case holds, that the PK plus 1 case holds. And what we do is we replace K in the induction hypothesis with K plus 1. So 3K plus 1 is less than K plus 1 factorial. This is what we want to show. I wrote a question mark above the inequality because I'm not assuming that's true. So let's start on the left-hand side here. And let's notice that 3k plus 1 by the rules of exponents can be written as 3k times 3 to the 1. So a good place to start would be the induction hypothesis. The induction hypothesis says that 3k is less than k factorial. I use the IH here, and that's awesome. All right, so 3k, 3 raised to k is less than k factorial is true by the induction hypothesis. Now multiply both sides by 3. We can do this, obviously, because 3 is greater than 0. It does not affect the inequality at all. So let's multiply. Three times 3k is less than 3 times k factorial is true because the induction hypothesis multiplying by 3 does not affect that inequality. And so notice that 3k plus 1 is equal to 3k times 3, 1, then that's going to be less than 3k factorial. So again, we're building this inequality. Let's take a quick glance at the right-hand side here. The right-hand side, we have k plus 1 factorial. In a factorial, it's descending multiplication. So this is literally k plus 1 times k minus 1 times k minus 2. All the way down to 2, and again, I love to include 1. So that's what k plus 1 factorial is. Now I can group k times k minus 1 times k minus 2 all the way down to 2 and 1. And notice that this is really just k factorial. So k plus 1 times k factorial. So there's a reason we're writing it this way. Again, we're building inequality. So I'm trying to compare k plus 1 factorial to 3 times k factorial. So notice here that k plus 1 factorial We have it rewritten as k plus 1 times k factorial. Okay, getting there. Now, k is greater than 6. So which means that, well, whatever we pick for k, it's going to be greater than 6. And obviously 6 is greater than 3. So when I have 3k factorial, this will be less than k times k factorial, because k will be at least 7. And this will certainly be less than k plus 1 times k factorial, since k plus 1 has to be at least 8. Let me write this better. All right, so 3k factorial is less than k times k factorial is less than k plus 1 times k factorial. So let's put all of this back together again. We have all of these inequalities that we've established. So we've had 3k plus 1, which we said is 3k times 3 to the 1, which is less than 3 times k factorial, which is less than k times k factorial, which is less than k plus 1 times k factorial, which is, as we've shown above, k plus 1 factorial. So this long line of inequalities allows us to say 3k plus 1 by transitivity will be less than k plus 1 factorial. And that's exactly what we wanted to show. We wanted to show that the next case is also true. So we've proven that 3 to the n is less than n factorial. And that's it. That wraps it up. You can put a little square as the proof's over, or some students like QED. However you want to end it, that is it. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe if you can. It helps us. And look forward to some other inequality induction proofs coming up. Thanks.